Alright, so hello YouTubers and such. Now that I've got my Korg Nano Series 2 out of the box, hooked up to my Ableton Live, played around with it a little bit. This is some cool stuff I found out about it, and yeah, they're just pretty much amazing. Alright, so first things first, the buttons. Alright, so I'm going to hit it light. You can barely hear it. Now I'm going to hit it hard and like put a little bit of pressure into it. See the volume difference? It's got velocity in the key set and such like that. The XY pad, because I'm using a sample, or here, I'll go on my Ableton and I'll pull up a standard noise so you can actually hear this. I'll just use this random bass, I guess. There we go. So, alright, so the touch scale. This is cool because it's got like a K oscillator built right in. You can also set the scale for the touchpad. If you can see it, it's right here. It says scale slash tap on it. My iPhone's been a bit buggy for my camera quality lately. But yeah, so that's a cool thing. Now they got, for drum rolls and such, they have the gate arpeggiator. You just hit that on. See how it's flashing? That's my sync flash, I guess, in a sense. So what I'm going to do is, now that I have both the touch scale and the gate arpeggiator on, I'm going to show you what's cool about this. So basically, I have myself a touchpad synth right here. This is all I really need for making music. But the pads, they work just as well, and they're actually better for making drums and beats and stuff. What I'm doing there is I'm using my pointer to hold the button down. I'm using my pinky finger to run across the XY pad to kind of throw in the gate arpeggiating and stuff. Because I'm holding the phone with my other hand, I don't really have two hands. I'm going to turn that off. Second thing is the nano keys. A bit of a problem with it. The keys, they feel like laptop keyboard keys. They're just really glorified, really big. They are better than the Nano 1 keys, but they're not that great. I feel like I have to be really careful with this, but I'm told it's kind of durable, not overly durable, but, you know, it can take a bit more. But anyways, so this is cool. You can set your octaves, press it once, it goes green, then orange, and then red, and then flashes red. Same with the minus octave, too, and you hit the minus octave. It's no lights on to know that you're in the standard positioning. It's got a modulation button, which is awesome. The pitch bend, this is cool. Yeah, it kind of gives you like a guitar wobble sort of thing. That's neat. I don't really play with the key too much though. Like I said, it feels kind of weird with the keys on my fingers, but I do highly suggest buying it. It is a nice piece. And then I get to the control pad. Now, if you look at this, it's pretty much set up just like Ableton. It's got your volume thing here. If you choose to set it up that way, you got your little twisty knob for your sends or whatever you're going to do with it. You also have the S button, which is probably a send button, or stop, whatever you want to make it, really. You can program this to do whatever. It's got an M button in the middle, which is probably going to be mute for most people. And the R at the bottom, record, arm. That's my guess to it. Like, that's the best possible outcome I can come up with and the easiest way to think about it. Now over here, it's got the record button, a play button, a stop button, a fast forward and rewind, which is awesome for making stuff. But also, you can also set markers and switch through your markers, cycle through them. You can place them down. You can jump through your tracks, which is neat. All this sort of stuff helps out quite a bit. I pretty much don't even have to use a mouse or a keyboard anymore at all. I just do just for the fun of it, I guess. But yeah. So the other night I used this dial, the top first dial, or I guess that was last night. I used it just to set an LFO on one of my sounds, one of my bass sounds, to make the wobble noise. And it actually really helped. It was really nice using it. Saved me from clicking around in my computer and trying to jump to this and that. I have a sample loaded up here just to show people that, yes, you can sample with this. You just need a program that'll let you sample, right? So right now I have a tiny segment of Enrique, or Enrique, whatever his name is, that Iglesias dude. A song called Heartbeat by him and Nicole Schwartz or whatever. I don't know. But I'm still connected to here. Do this. Alright, so there's... So yeah, I'm not trying to do anything or play anything there. I'm just basically trying to show you that, yes, you can sample with this. And for these three, it cost me under $200 at Long & McQuaid in Toronto, on Bloor Street West. It's been a major help, actually, and I highly suggest it to anybody. You can order them offline from various different music stores. Yeah, I think everybody should check it out. And if you don't want to check this out, at least get the Korg IK Oscillator app from the App Store and iTunes, because that is a wonderful app as well, just for fun, even. Alrighty, have a good one.